السلام عليكم ورحمة الله.
الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعين به ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله تعالى من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا إنه من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله بلغ الرسالة وأدى الأمانة ونصح للأمة فكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل ربه حق جهاده حتى أتاه اليقين وتركنا على المحجة البيضاء ليلها كنهارها لا يزيغ عنها إلا هالك يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وأحسن الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وما قل وكفى خير مما كثر وألهى وإنما توعدون لأجل ما أنتم بمعجزين إخوة الإيمان والإسلام أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله عز وجل All praises due to Allah May Allah's peace and blessings be upon His Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I bear witness that there is no one worthy of worship but Allah alone without any partners. And I bear witness that Muhammad Rasulullah is the true slave servant, prophet, and last messenger of Rabbul Alameen. May Allah's peace and blessings be upon him, his household, his companions, and everyone following him until the day of judgment. I ask Allah Azza wa Jalla in the beginning of this khutbah to bless our gathering, to purify our intentions and fix our deeds, to forgive our sins and make us among those who listen and follow the best of what they listen to. Allahumma ameen. My dear brothers and sisters, we always talk about how can we bring the Book of Allah into practice. How can we bring it to real life? How can we manifest what Allah Azza wa Jalla wants us to be in His Book subhanahu wa ta'ala? And we also emphasize that the only way to do that the only way to achieve that is to start by following a real life human role model, who is Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ لِمَنْ كَانَ يَرْجُ اللَّهَ وَالْيَوْمَ الْآخِرَ وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا. Allah says in the Quran, and truly, verily, you have the best of role models in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam for those who seek Allah Azza wa Jal and who seek to be saved in the Day of Judgment and who are always consistently remembering Allah and being engaged in the remembrance of Allah. We'll be engaged in the remembrance of Allah by our heart, by our tongues, and through our actions. وَذَكَرَ اللَّهَ كَثِيرًا يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا اذْكُرُوا اللَّهَ ذِكْرًا كَثِيرًا وَسَبِّحُوهُ بُكْرَةً وَأَصِيلًا. O you who believe, mention Allah, remember Allah as much as you can, and engage specifically in tasbih. Even though tasbih is in zikr, Allah Azza wa Jalla said, remember Allah. But then Allah said, make tasbih in the morning and at night. Even though tasbih is part of the zikr, but it is more important, that's why it is emphasized. Sometimes Allah Azza wa Jalla in the Quran tells us a general order, then He tells us or highlights part of that order. وَالْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. Everybody's in loss. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Those who believe. Those who believe are Muslims. They believe in Allah and they pray and they fast and they give zakat, sadaqah, and do all the good deeds. It is enough. الْعَصْرِ إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَفِي خُسْرٍ. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. We got it. But Allah Azza wa Jalla said, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. Even though part of Iman is to do عمل الصالح, yet Allah Azza wa Jalla says that do عمل الصالح. There's more emphasis. Alright, then part of good deeds is to advise each other to do good. It is understood. Yet Allah Azza wa Jalla says, وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ. Advise each other with good. And because advising each other with good, it is going to bring hard feelings, it's going to bring people who resist, it's going to bring issues and challenges. Allah Azza wa Jal said, وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. Again. So the Quran is always like that. So we say that we need to bring that Quran in our life. Iman. What is the Iman? We look at the Quran and see Allah described the believers. إنما المؤمنون truly the believers الذين إذا ذكر الله وجلت قلوبهم. When the name of Allah is mentioned, their hearts will tremble. Is that you? Is that me? Is that us? If it is yes, alhamdulillah. If it is not, then how can we achieve it? You continue reading the Quran and it will describe to you how you develop the khashya of Allah. How you develop the khashya of Allah? Through the ilm. إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. So the more knowledge you do, the more knowledge you get, the more khashya you will have in your heart. Then when the name of Allah is mentioned, you're going to have that feeling that qualifies you to be among the believers. You see the steps? You know, you go with the Quran, one verse at a time, it will lead you to another verse. And that verse lead you to another verse. And that verse lead you to another hadith. And that hadith lead you to read the seerah of Rasulullah. And that the seerah of Rasulullah want you to seek knowledge. then you learn the fiqh and the ahkam, and the ahkam makes you fear Allah more, then you become a believer, and the circle keeps going on and on and on. That's why the believer has to be always remembering Allah. Now you know what is the remembrance of Allah mean? It's not only saying subhanAllah, astaghfirullah, alhamdulillah, I said 100 times, I'm done for today. That's not the point. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam prays a whole night. Same rak'ah, one rak'ah only, one, all night. And he is reciting one ayah. Just one ayah. Can you imagine that? Would you do that? Can you imagine that you start saying Allahu Akbar, read Surah Al-Fatiha, and you start saying إِن تُعَذِّبْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُ وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. Oh Allah, if you punish them, they are truly your servants. And if you forgive them, you are the most dignified, the all-wise. And he keep repeating it. So you repeat it 1, 3 times, 10 times, 50 times, then you get bored. But those who mention Allah, those who feel it in their heart echoes what their tongue says, of course it is going to reflect in their action. Of course it will reflect on the action. Then they enjoy that salat. Then they know they are in the presence of Allah. They know they are standing in front of their Creator. Then one ayah or two ayah, it doesn't matter anymore how long is the surah or that. I am in the salah, I am in the meeting with my Lord. That's what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is showing us. So the same point I started the khutbah with, we want to bring Quran into practical life. And the only way to interpret Quran and understand it so it becomes an action and the life of ours is only looking at someone who did. Remember what I said. Okay? So Quran is there. I want to live the Quran, ya akhi. Alright? Go ahead. But this Quran was not sent directly from Allah to you. This was not. Allah chose someone else. Human. So you and me and everybody until the day of judgment can learn from. Who is that? Muhammad Rasulullah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That is the importance of the sunnah of Rasulullah. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers, when you tell your children pray sunnah, it is not just an extra act over the obligation. You're connecting them with Muhammad Rasulullah. When you wake up before Fajr and pray 2 rak'ah, you know, and then you pray your witr, you are connected with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. After you give your zakah, you give the sadaqah, you are connecting with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. All the extra a'mal, you are being a follower practically of Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Think about it like that. Then you will love the nafil. You will love to do the sunnah. You will love just, you know what? I have a half hour. I should go and find a quiet place and I sit and say, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah, Astaghfirullah. Who among us will do that? Half hour? Let me go grab lunch. I have 45 minutes. Oh, there is a restaurant a little bit further. Now I'm going to go because I have extra time. See, you want to enjoy more. Nothing wrong. But I'm just telling you how we prioritize our life. Okay? There is a restaurant, but it would take me an extra 10 minutes to go. But I only have an hour. So I'm satisfied with that little restaurant over here. To go pick up my lunch so I can go back to work. If they give you an hour, then you are going to go to the extra one because what? It will give you more satisfaction. Huh? Time. You have time only to come and pray Jumu'ah. What if that hour extended a little bit? Would you sit in the masjid and do some extra nafil? Ask yourself. Or you are going to find something else extra in life you will do because you have extra time. That's my question to us today. So if you have some extra time, what is the priority that will come in your head? Something extra for the deen or something extra for the dunya? Both are extras. Both are extras. You're going to make some more money. You're going to have some enjoyment in halal. I'm talking halal, not haram. Haram is out of the question. خلاص. But we're talking about extra halal stuff. And I give you the restaurant stuff, you know. Instead of a sub, you're going to go eat, mashallah, nice stuff, you know. Bread, korma, biryani, things like that. Yeah, I mean, good stuff. So instead of this, you want extra. This is food and that's food. But this is more enjoyment. And also at the same time, you're going to pray Jum'ah and run. But now you have some time. Are you going to pray two more rak'ah? Are you going to sit and read one page of the Quran? Are you going to sit and do some istighfar? It's open. Choice is open. And that is how you bring Quran to life. We always ask, why I don't have khushu? Why I don't have submission to Allah? Why I'm not feeling the ibadah? Because of this. When you have some extra time, what do? First thing you turn to is your TV, is your iPhone and Facebook, or the Book of Allah. And why do I keep asking, the Book of Allah is not in our life, the Book of Allah is not in our life. Yeah, Shaykh, why the Ummah is asleep? What is this? What is that? People ask all these kind of questions. Why you have to go far? لا تذهب بعيدا أخي الحبيب. والله لو كفر. انظر لنفسك وعرف الإجابة. Look at yourself, you will not answer. Don't look far, yeah. Don't look far that the Ummah is this, the Ummah is that, why the Muslim this, why the Muslim that. But it's a Muslim. Yeah, I mean, all this Muslim as if it is another entity. Me and you are part of this entity you are asking about, aren't we? Aren't we?
Yes.
Then we look. Ibda binafsik. Start with yourself. You will count things that you will see your life of 60, 70, or 80 years. Wallahi, not enough to fix your own issues. I swear. The time, if Allah knows, I have another 50 years in my life, Allah knows. I think they are not enough to fix my own issues. If I work every day, constantly. Because issues keep popping up, defects keep popping up. I am a man who is emotional, who likes, who dislikes, who hates, and who loves, who's up, who's down. Someday you are okay, someday you are not okay. Issues, there are issues. If every day in the morning I wake up and I want to make sure that I'm closer to Allah and I'm further from shaitan, I got a full day of work. Full day of work. Every day, ikhwani, make this experiment for the week until next Friday. This assignment I'm giving myself a week. Starting inshallah tomorrow morning, if Allah give us life, wake up in the morning, say, you know what? Today, I want to do everything possible to be closer to Allah and away from the shaitan. That's that one assignment. That will lead you to ask yourself a question before every action and every thought. Would this get me closer to Allah and far from shaitan or not? Would this do me closer to Allah or not? I'm going to go to work now. Is this work getting me closer to Allah and far from shaitan or not? I want to look to ahram now. Is this getting me closer to Allah and far from shaitan or not? I'm going to eat this food. Is this food getting me closer to Allah or not? I'm talking with that person. These people are backbiting in front of me. Is this going to get me closer to Allah or not? Someone is doing wrong and I'm quiet. Is this going to get me closer to Allah or not? You're busy. Do you think you're going to worry about me now? You're going to worry about me when you are busy on yourself like this? I mean, if you have a debt, credit card debts and all that, and now, mashallah, the American average debt is like $20,000 to $22,000, you know, per person, you know, the average debt. Congratulations. Anyways, if you have that debt, why you worry about mine? Why would you worry about mine? No, if you have a debt and you wake up in the morning and you know that this debt is increasing and they charge you interest and you want to go in the hole and your check is this and that, isn't that enough concern for you to mind your own self? Yes or no? Actually, the way you look at everybody around you, how can they be helped to pay my debt? It is not like, how much debt, ya akhi, do you have? Let's work it out how we can pay your debt. And then you just go worry about your own, man. Just go worry about your own. You know, somebody coming to me and they have a problem and they need to see a doctor. said, Sheikh, you don't look good. Your eyes are red. You need to see a doctor. Look who's talking. You know, well, this is normal human act. But when it comes to our relationship with Allah Azza wa Jal, we're not busy with ourselves. It's a Dawah. We're always criticizing everybody else. We need to stop. See what Allah Azza wa Jal is saying in the Quran, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala. Allah Azza wa Jal said, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu, qu anfusakum. Qu anfusakum wa ahlikum nara wa quduha an-nas wal hijara. You know, when you get to the airplane, they tell you, in case the pressure, whatever, we memorize that one. This device mask will come. Then what they say? Put yours first. Huh? And then help someone, the other person beside you. Someone said, how come I put it before my own child? Yeah, because if you put it, you can help your own child. But if you go and help your child, maybe you're out of breath, and you don't help your child, then you don't help yourself. So you help yourself first, so at least you can see what's next. والله عز وجل يقول يا أيها الذين آمنوا قوا أنفسكم. Save yourself first. How you can save someone from hellfire and you go in? That's the dua. You seek refuge in Allah from being the reason for people to go to Jannah, like a bridge, they cross over and we fall in hellfire. Would you like that? Would you like yourself to be that? Nobody. How you like to help everybody pay their debt and you drown in debt? What did you do? You're helping everybody and you forget yourself. أتأمرون الناس بالبر وتنسون أنفسكم؟ يعني أنفسكم الأول. أتأمرون الناس بالبر وتنسون أنفسكم وأنتم تتلون الكتاب أفلا تعقلون؟ يعني عقل mind, sanity dictates that you are going to teach something, people going to see if you're doing it or not. So you should start with yourself first. Then when you preach, people will see. Yeah. Allah Azza wa Jal describing those who recite the book of Allah, not only recite, but it comes to their actions. Like I said in the beginning, when Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when I'm reciting this ayah to you, you will see every part of the ayah, each and every one of us can actually identify something from what they heard about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that he applied that ayah. For sure. For sure. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ وَأَنْفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً يَرْجُونَ تِجَارَةً لَنْ تَبُورُ. Allah Azza wa Jal said, those who recite the book of Allah, and who else would recite the book of Allah better than the person who received it, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Anyone of us here think that you can recite the Quran better than Muhammad Rasulullah? Huh? Who? So he is the best. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَتْلُونَ كِتَابَ اللَّهِ أَوَّلُهُمُ النَّبِيُّ صلى الله عليه وسلم. First one. And this tilawa reflect on their iqama of salah. How a person would recite Quran and does not do his or her salah properly? Of course, well. وَأَقَامُوا الصَّلَاةِ. And that emphasis here, according to Arabic language, that emphasis when it is here, it tells us that their salah is special. Then وَأَنْفَقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاهُمْ سِرًّا وَعَلَانِيَةً. Allah says, and they spend from what we provided them openly and secretly. The ulama said openly عن الزكاة, secretly عن الصدقة. And others said, you know, you can spend the zakah and the sadaqah openly and secretly to encourage people and all of that. That's okay. Yani, interpretation is what? Why they are doing this? Reciting the book of Allah, doing their prayer properly, and spending openly and secretly. يَرْجُونَ تِجَارَةً لَمْ تَبُوْسِ. These are the foundation of a successful business. Trade. You know, they tell you, like, if you want to do business, you have to do a market study, you have to have the good advertisement team, the accounting, the management, the sales, this and that, and HR, you know, this is the business. Allah Azza wa Jalla here says, trade with me, you purchasing the Jannah, and I give it to you, and I will customize the product. So you want a palace, you want two, you want 10, you want how many trees, you want a fence around it, you want a fountain, you want rivers, you want these things, okay. You tell me, I will do it. But you have to do those three. Decide the book of Allah and understand it and implement it. Do your salah properly and make salah reflect as the Quran says. Because Quran says each one of those. ورتل القرآن ترتيلا وتدو القرآن Quran is mentioned in the Quran, how you do with it. That's number one. Salah is mentioned in the Quran, how you do it. Number two. Spending mentioned in the Quran, everything around it. And the Sunnah of Rasulullah showed us all of that. So this way, how we reflect on the Quran, how we bring Quran in our life, may Allah make us among those who understand the Quran and reflect on the Quran and live the Sunnah of Rasulullah. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه وبعد. My dear brothers and sisters, this subject is a subject of lifetime. What I mean by lifetime? It's a lifetime of learning. Will not finish until we die. It finishes by our death, by departing this world. So nobody can say, I achieved what I'm saying today. No, you will not achieve everything. You are always going through the perfection. But it will stop when you stop living. So don't take it as a 1 week thing or a 1 month thing. No. We want to live Quran. To live Quran, you have to look at a role model who teaches you how to understand the Quran. And this is Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So point number one, Quran, Sunnah, same package together. How we can do this? Seeking the knowledge. Seek knowledge. As a Muslim, do not be satisfied to sleep any given day without knowing something that you did not know yesterday. Those are the two things I'm going to end the khutbah with. Quran and Sunnah, your package to live the book of Allah Azza wa Jalla. Look at Rasulullah and learn. How are you going to do that? Somebody has to teach you this, and they have to put constant commitment, constant effort, sincere commitment to do it. How you are going to do it? You will never be satisfied that you sleep any given day without knowing something new that you did not know yesterday. If we have that commitment today, may Allah save us subhanahu wa ta'ala. رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا ذُنُوبَنَا وَكَفِّرْ عَنَّا سَيِّئَاتِنَا وَتَوَفَّنَا مَعَ الْأَبْرَارِ. رَبَّنَا اغْفِرْ لَنَا وَارْحَمْنَا وَأَنْتَ خَيْرُ الرَّاحِمِينَ. اللهم إنا نسألك الهدى والتقى والعفاف والغنى. اللهم اكفنا بحلالك عن حرامك ومن فضلك عن من سواك. اللهم لا تدع لنا ذنبا الا غفرته ولا هما الا فرجته ولا مريضا الا شفيته ولا ميتا الا رحمته ولا ضالا الا هديته ولا دينا الا قضيته ولا حاجه لك فيها رضا ولنا فيها صلاحا الا قضيتها ويسرتها رب العالمين. اللهم انصر اخواننا المستضعفين في كل ارض ومكان. اللهم انصر الاسلام والمسلمين ووحد رايتنا يا رب العالمين. وانصرنا على اعدائك اعداء الدين. عباد الله ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. واقم الصلاه.